Let's talk matrix multiplication. There's a lot to remember about all the rules and identity and zero matrices, so let's just jump right in. Let's start with the simple fact that multiplying any matrix by a scalar that's outside of the matrix just means that you're supposed to multiply every entry in the matrix by the scalar. The dimensions of the matrix don't matter. Every number in the matrix gets multiplied by that scalar. But what about when we want to multiply one matrix by another matrix instead of just by a scalar? Well, we first have to say that unlike real number multiplication, where 7 times 9 always gives you the same result as 9 times 7, matrix multiplication is not commutative, meaning that you can't just flip the order of the multiplication and get the same result. The result of this multiplication is this, but if I flip the order of the multiplication, the resulting matrix is totally different. So matrix multiplication is not commutative. Order matters. So we know that matrix multiplication isn't commutative, but what about the other algebraic properties? With matrices, the associative property does apply, which means that given matrices A, B, and C, this equation holds true. That's because whether we multiply A by B, and then that result by C, or multiply B by C, and then multiply A by that result, the order of the multiplication is still A onto B onto C, so the associative property holds. For the same reason, the distributive property also holds, so A times the quantity B plus C is the same as A times B plus A times C. About matrix dimensions when we're multiplying. First, we need to say that matrix dimensions are always given as rows by columns. So a 2x3 matrix is a matrix with 2 rows and 3 columns. When it comes to matrix multiplication, not all matrices can even be multiplied together in the first place. In order to be able to multiply two matrices, you need the first matrix to have the same number of columns as the number of rows in the second matrix. I can multiply these together since the first matrix has 2 columns and the second matrix has 2 rows. This works too because I've still got 2 columns matched up to 2 rows. But here I have 3 columns matched up to 2 rows. Since those don't match, the product of these matrices is undefined and I can't multiply them. So if we take the example of multiplying a 2x3 matrix by a 3x4 matrix, right away, we know that the result is defined, since the number of columns in the first matrix matches the number of rows in the second. If these numbers don't match, then we know immediately that we can't do the multiplication and that the result is undefined. But besides comparing these numbers to see whether or not the multiplication is defined, we can also look at these two outside numbers to know the dimensions of the result. It'll be 2x4. If we multiply a 3x3 by a 3x2, we know it's defined because these match, and we know the result will be a 3x2. Now we should say that matrix multiplication is all about dot products. What's a dot product? Well, when I find the dot product of two coordinate points, I multiply the x values together, multiply the y values together, and then add those products. That's the dot product. We do the exact same thing when we multiply matrices. So to get 19, we take the dot product of 1, 2, and 5, 7. To get 22, we take the dot product of 1, 2, and 6, 8. We get 43 from the dot product of 3, 4, and 5, 7. And to get 50, we take the dot product of 3, 4, and 6, 8. Now to remember what to put where, you can say that the first entry in the resulting matrix will be the dot product of the first row from the first matrix and the first column from the second matrix. So first row, first column. The dot product of the first row and second column goes here. The second row and first column here. And the second row, second column here. Now, if we factor out this RC row column abbreviation, we're left with 11, 12, 21, and 22. Don't forget, these aren't real numbers. They're just representations of the first row by the first column, first row by the second column, etc. So 11, 12, 21, 22 is just an easy way to remember what to do. Okay, identity matrices. They're important when we're talking about matrix multiplication. These are identity matrices. Any matrix with ones on the diagonal like this, from upper left to lower right, and zeros everywhere else. Identity matrices are always square matrices, meaning that they have the same number of rows and columns. So this is a 2x2 identity matrix, which we can abbreviate as I2, and this is a 4x4 identity matrix, which we can abbreviate as I4. Identity matrices are special because when we multiply a matrix by an identity matrix, we don't change the value of the original matrix. Just like multiplying a real number by 1 doesn't change the value of the real number. Because the identity matrix is like multiplying by 1, it means the identity matrix can come first or second in the multiplication, and the result will still be this original matrix. All we have to do is be careful with our dimensions. If we have a 2x3 matrix and we put the identity matrix in front, it's going to be I2. But if we put it second, it'll need to be I3. If we multiply two matrices together and we end up with an identity matrix as a result, it means those two matrices are what we call multiplicative inverses of each other. Not all matrices have a multiplicative inverse, but here's an example of multiplicative inverses. Multiplicative inverses can be multiplied in either order, and you'll still get an identity matrix. So if an identity matrix is like 1, what's the equivalent of 0 when we're talking about matrices? Well, the 0 matrix is a matrix full of zeros, and whenever we multiply a matrix by its associated 0 matrix, the result is going to be another matrix full of zeros. We always denote a 0 matrix with a capital O, just like we always denote an identity matrix with a capital I. We talked about the rules of algebra for matrices, matrix dimensions and which dimensions can be multiplied together, how to use dot products to multiply matrices, and all about identity and zero matrices. All these matrix multiplication rules just take a lot of getting used to, but I hope that helps.